Good morning. I am Sivayogi Sivarajan from Tirumular Yoga Siddha Peedam, Coimbatore, Tamil Nadu, South India. Now I am going to speak about light meditation. There are different kinds of meditation practiced in Hinduism. One such meditation is light meditation. In Hinduism, there are three kinds of worship. One, idol worship. Another is astrophysical worship. The third one is astral worship. In the beginning stage, one may start worshipping idols, but it is not recommended to worship forever. For the whole life, they should start with idol worship. From there, they step by step, they should improve from one stage to another. There are different kinds of stages. The idol worship is only the preliminary stage. There are four types of paths in Hinduism: Sariya, Kriya, Yoga and Jnana. So this comes under Sariya path. From Sariya path, one should lift above to second stage. So even this idol worship speaks of philosophy. They are not mere idols. If you look into the idols, just like Nataraja or Vinayaka, they speak of fivefold activities of God: creation, preservation, dissolution, veiling and blessing. But they should understand the philosophy and they should lift above the above mere idol worship. The second stage of idol worship is astrophysical worship. They lift themselves above half idol and half astral images. For example, Sivalinga. Sivalinga is having a particular shape, but it is not the shape of anybody or any personality. So this is a philosophic representation. In the same way, Jyoti meditation, he also comes in the second stage, astrophysical worship, because the Jyoti is not having a definite shape, but it is having a shape. So it comes in the midway between idol worship and astral worship. The nada becomes full and full astral worship. So this worship is also practiced by yogis to open up nadis and enjoy the divine bliss. This for practicing this meditation normally in our houses, we can select any one particular place and regularly sit in that place only. You should not change the place frequently. Then we should sit on a non-conductor, preferably a wood, or in the early times the yogis used tiger skins, deer skins, etc. But now they are banned. So one can use this darbha mat also for meditation. The purpose of the non-conductor seat is, when you meditate, this astral nerve current and biomagnetism will increase in your body. So they should not be wasted and earthed. So we are using a non-conductor. In the same way, a meditation practice should face east or north, because earth is a large magnet. We should not oppose the magnetic field of earth. So we should go in line with the magnetic field of earth. So we should face north or east. Then we should sit in any asana which is very convenient for meditation. For example, Padmasana, Siddhasanam, Swastik Asana, etc. The Padmasana is very ideal for this meditation. Because when you sit in Padmasana, the spinal cord will be erect. Moreover, your nervous system will be in a closed circuit, so that the astral nerve current will flow throughout your body uniformly. Moreover, if you sit in Padmasana, the blood circulation below the knee will be slowed down and blood circulation in the spinal cord area will be increased. So, this asana is also very important for this meditation. You take deep breaths, 5 deep breaths or 10 deep breaths, and start with the Sushumna light meditation. You should imagine a small piece of light in between the eyebrows, very bright. You should gaze it very deeply and remain in that position for some time. This is a Jyoti meditation of the Sushumna. This meditation will open up the Sushumna. Actually, the Sushumna is the junction box of the 10 prana energy tubes. Nadis, 10 nadis. The nadis are energy tubes. They are having connection. The 10 nadis are having connection in Sushumna. If you open up the Sushumna, the energy will flow through all the 10 large nadis. So, this practice very safe. In Hatha Yoga and other practices, the Sushumna 10 nadis are opened forcefully by doing Kumbhaka and Bandhas. Muladhara Bandha, Jalandhara Bandha and Uddiyana Bandha. They have some risk factors also. But this light meditation is safe and it takes some more time, but it is very safe. To concentrate on in between the eyebrows is not so easy. For practicing this, we can practice Threadagdi, the eye exercises. The eye exercises will help you to meditate for a long time. You can concentrate more by these Threadak exercises. First, these exercises, we can concentrate the look at the nail of the thumb. If you keep the thumb in parallel to your in between eyebrows and look it constantly, some kind of activation will be there in your brain. The same after that, you can concentrate in between at the tip of the nose with your eyes for some time. This will also activate your brain and cranial nerves. After that, you can concentrate in between the eyebrows with these mudras, Sambhavi mudras. When you practice this, your Sushumna area will be activated and it will tend to open. So this Kesari Mudra and Sambhavi Mudra also are very useful for opening the Sushumna Nadi. When the Sushumna Nadi is open, your energy will flow to this pituitary gland, pineal gland and to the top of crown and also back to the back of head. They are called Bindu Chakra. About this light meditation in between eyebrows, Saint Trimular says in the hymn 600, the translation is, in the undistracted light in between eyebrows, one sits gazing, becoming one with it. He says like that. After that, you take 5 breaths, deep breaths, and you meditate above the upper palate. You imagine a light above the upper palate and meditate it for some time. This he says in hymn 599. Annakin ulle ahanda oligati. Inside the palatal cavity, he shows the cosmic light. He gave the fleshly body that we redeemed be. That is the meaning of the hymn 599. You meditate for some time and you have take a 5 deep breaths. And you imagine a light above your crown. This meditation is also recommended in Siddha literature. For example, there is one mountain called Annamalai. In Annamalai, every December they are lighting one huge light on the hill, and lakhs of devotees come around the hill and worship this Jyoti. Philosophically, the mountain is head and the Jyoti is the this Jyoti meditation above the crown. In the same way, in Ayyappa, Jyoti is also shown in Sabarimala to facilitate, to guide the practitioners to focus on light. About this meditation, he says in 619 hymn, Andamilla Arvin Parambarul Sundara Jyotiyum Thonjidum Thane. The wonderful light, timeless knowledge will appear. Then the imagine a light that is above head. That is, the Sahasrara is called the seventh Adhara, but above this, the eighth Adhara is there. That is called Guru Mandala, or Turiyapuvi, or Sagasiradala. We should also imagine a light in that area. About this, he shows, says in hymn 589, there on the stony area Mount Meru, the Lord performs his timeless dance. That unending bliss I witnessed. Tirumala says that he has also witnessed that light in that area. He has practiced this meditation and achieved success in meditation. He says in this hymn. In another hymn, 601, he says of this Chandra Mandala, Oru Poludhu Unnar Chandra Poovaye. Even once they meditate not, the ordinary men do not know the importance of such meditation. There is a glowing lotus above the head, which is fit for meditation. Then again take some deep breaths and meditate on the chest area, that is the Anahata Chakra. Normally people meditate on the Anahata Chakra. The Anahata Chakra is having 12 petals. You imagine the 12 petals are very glowing, and imagine a light in that Anahata Chakra. If you do this practice, your thymus will be activated. The endocrine gland thymus will be activated. And the kindness and mercy will be followed by this practitioner. Regarding this meditation, he says in hymn 602, light the lamp of mind and dispel the darkness of ego, extinguish fire of wrath and brighten lamps within. Thenceforth alike, then the mind's lamp is an unending lamp indeed. That's when you extinguish the fire of anger, and after that you light the light of wisdom or light of love, then it will not die out. The light will be there forever. So it is very important to leave anger. You should transcend anger. So it is important for the yogis. Then only unending love will be experienced by the yogi or meditation practitioner. So the spiritual path recommends love and kindness towards all living beings, and even to plants they are showing, extending their love. This in hymn 603 also he says, if you look into the nadis inside, he will be one with you, just like a glass transparent. That is, when you imagine the whole body, whole nadis, the nadis are actually present from top to toe. For through the nadis only the energies are flowing. You I imagine a light filled with all the 72,000 nadis. That is from Sahasrara to big toes. That is very important for this light meditation. Then take 5 more deep breaths and meditate Jyoti at the Mooladhara. The Mooladhara also there is the Kundalini Devi. This is Parasakti, Valai Parameshwari. She is also in the form of light, glowing light. We should meditate on it, and when we meditate on it, it will be useful for bringing the light to the head. That is also very important for this. The meditation practitioner of Jyoti will finally attain Mukti. He will reach the lotus feet of Lord Shiva. The lotus feet of Lord Shiva are also glowing. He says that Kadikonde Isan Kalal Cheralame. The practitioner of this will reach the glowing lotus feet of Lord Shiva. And he crosses the ocean of births and deaths. He transcends everything. He transcends the 5 senses, he transcends the 6 adharas, he transcends the 5 elements, and he transcends time and space, and becomes one with Shiva. So, practice light meditation and enjoy bliss of God. We are teaching this meditation in our ashram and outside the country also. Those who want to learn, or those who want to organize my programs in foreign countries, you can contact me at mysticthirumoola@gmail.com. mysticthirumoola@gmail.com. Even if 4 or 5 persons are there, I will come to your place and teach all kinds of meditations and yoga, pranayama, told by Saint Thirumoola, who is an ancient rishi who wrote only in Tamil, and his teachings are now only coming out to the outer world. So make use of it. Thank you.